Hi, this is Greg McCoach, editor of the Mining Speculator. I'm here with President and CEO Jeff Wilson of Precipitate Gold. We're here at the Metals Investor Forum in September of 2019. Jeff.
Great. Good to see you.
Glad you could be here. Yeah, exciting time. We're really getting excited about our market now.
Absolutely.
After a long hiatus, you know, of being in the down cycle, people are getting excited again. You can tell by the crowds that are coming here to the show. Investors want to know what they should buy. And as president and CEO of a solid gold company that I've followed, I was an investor at one point. Why don't you give us the latest update on where you're at right now?
Sure. Yeah, I mean, you're right. We're certainly into, you know, what looks to be the beginning of a really exciting gold market here. You know, we were fortunate. I think we're sort of an indicator here of the kind of market we've come out of where, you know, good companies can find good assets. We were fortunate enough to have a strong asset in the Dominican Republic.
Yes.
That we've been working for the last 6 or 7 years. There's been some, you know, slight political issues with respect to what's going on a permitting on an adjacent project that, you know, we kind of put that on hold a little bit. But, you know, during that down cycle, we were able to go out and say, okay, what else is available that we can add value, bring into the company at what we hoped at the time would be an inexpensive entry point, but had all the right sort of bells and whistles to be a project that in a gold market that's working,
right,
would make a lot of sense. And so we picked up an asset adjacent to one of the largest gold mining operations in the world. That's in Central Dominican Republic. So we surround barracks Pueblo Viejo,
right,
on three sides.
That's huge, yeah.
And aside from sort of a real estate play, what we're most excited about from a technical standpoint is there's some pretty interesting historic drill results from certain portions of the project that we plan to explore more in more detail down the road. But the most compelling target is literally, you know, adjacent to barracks mining pits.
Right.
And represents a highly prospective zone that really had not been adequately drilled in the past. And so you've got a big target in a big, rich environment,
right,
in what, as you just mentioned, you know, looks to be a rising gold market. So
right,
it's exciting times for us.
Yeah. If I remember right, I was on a site visit down there a long, long time ago, but there was another company that made a discovery down there. Do you remember that? I'm trying to think of the name of that junior.
In country or in that specific region or just in country?
Yes.
So that was a company called GoldQuest.
GoldQuest, that was
it.
I couldn't think of the name. That's right.
And there's a tie in there because GoldQuest in 2012 made that phenomenal discovery.
Right.
Their share price went from 6 cents to $2 almost overnight. As I was just mentioning to someone earlier today, they, at the time of that discovery, they were restricted. They'd maxed out their allowable ground.
Yeah.
And so GoldQuest wasn't able to acquire any more ground right after they made that discovery.
Right.
And Precipitate came in on the heels of that back in 2012 and
right,
picked up, you know, 12,000 hectares right against GoldQuest concession or claim boundaries. So we still hang on to that ground. We've got
right,
drill permits for 100 different drill pad locations
right,
on that ground. It's very similar geology to what GoldQuest has at Romero.
Right.
And Romero is now at a PEA stage. Well advanced, but it is awaiting some environmental permitting to be able to get that to the exploitation stage. So still very much a going concern. It's just a bit of a waiting game there politically.
Yeah.
And so for a junior company, especially in the market we've had for the last, you know, 12 or more months, but certainly the last 12 months, we thought that, you know, the better use of our time and money to go to a part of the country where, you know, permitting is more readily available. We're within 10 kilometers of three other existing mines. So it's a much more mining friendly part of the country.
Right. And you can drill year round.
Correct.
That's so exciting because so many of these drill plays, you know, they're very limited, especially up in the Golden Triangle where everybody's putting a lot of effort and a lot of time and money. You know, you got a 5 month window max,
right,
and you're sitting on no news for the rest of the year. So that's a little difficult as a company, as a promotion, as a, you know, a newsletter writer trying to cover a story like that. So this is very good. I like what you're saying. And any other projects around the world? Just everything's in the Dominican at this point?
Yeah, we've stayed focused on the Dominican Republic. It's an area that we think is, you know, largely underexplored, but highly mineralized, as proven by Barrick's. You know, Barrick's deposit there is 20 million ounces
of
gold.
I know, it's huge.
I mean, it's a monster. Yeah. And like I said, it's one of the top five operations on the planet.
Right.
So this is a country that, you know, not a lot of people think about when they think about mining and exploration.
Right.
But mining is a very, because of Barrick's Pueblo Viejo, it's one of the more important contributors to the economy. Yet there's a lot of, you know, available untested ground there. So we've put in now 7 or 8 years worth of commitment to the country. That's put us in a position where, you know, we know the system. We know the politicians, we know the business leaders, you know, we sort of know how to get things done. Yeah, we've pretty much done the things we said we were going to do, and that, you know, puts us in a good position doing business there. So for us, we think, you know, we want to remain focused. We've got a little bit of diversity within the country, having the two distinct assets.
Yeah.
But our focus right now is to target in on an extensive number of drill targets that we've put together over the last several years.
Yeah.
And hopefully, again, in this market where, you know, perhaps capital and interest from the market starts to rise again, you know, we can put to the market a really interesting dynamic drill play here in the next few months.
Yeah, sounds good. How are we for cash? What do we need to raise more money, or is there going to be any financings? Or?
Yeah, we're in a position now where we've got a little in around $500,000 in the treasury. Our projects are all owned outright, so there's no underlying option payments or work commitments. But in order to gear up for a next phase of drilling, the plan would be to go back to the market and do some sort of an equity raise. Again, I'm lucky enough that Precipitate has a really strong existing shareholder base.
Oh, for sure.
So we've got a couple of key current shareholders who have made it known to me or to us that they're in for pretty significant lead orders whenever we're ready to finance for this new project. So I don't think that the task of generating the capital to go drilling will be too difficult. So, you know, we should be able to turn that around pretty quickly. And really what I'm waiting for right now is a final permit on drill permitting for this new project at Pueblo Grande, and then we'll execute on a financing.
And we're thinking, what, October, November-ish?
Yeah, I think, I mean, in terms of financing, it could be sooner. But in terms of getting up and running, I'd like to be drilling come October, November, something like that.
Perfect.
So we're pretty close to being able to get the drills turning and get boots on the ground. So
Well, keep me posted on that. I'd like to be part of the financing. So
absolutely.
What's the share price right now?
We're currently trading about 10, 11 cents Canadian on the TSX-V.
And share structure is what?
Yeah, we've got, the company's been around for a long time now. We've got 82 million shares issued and outstanding.
That's still good, though, for that.
It's still reasonably. We haven't rolled back or consolidated at any point. There's no warrants currently outstanding on the company, so there's not a lot of overhang. We haven't had a financing or an equity financing since 2016, so we've been really good at managing, you know, the treasury but I think at such time as we've got some compelling targets, which we just announced a news release, sort of early September here, with respect to drill targets on this new project, I think that can be a real catalyst for us to generate, you know, some capital for financing and get in and get drilling here in the next couple months.
Well, wish you the best of luck. That's
great.
Exciting.
Great. Thank you very much.
I'm behind you.